justice!
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 Desire! Ah! 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 Ah!
Something together tonight. We're going to start out with a little science. I'll learn about this miraculous creation we live in right now. Amen. We have, it just so happens, in the choir, a biocellular genius named Dr. Ben Duba Taylor. Here he comes. Is that the way scientists dance?
I contain multitudes, says a line in Walt Whitman's poem, Song of Myself. Whitman was not thinking in biological terms, but the line has biological resonance. Recent studies suggest that each of us, in addition to the trillions of cells that make up our own bodies, each of us possess cells that have descended from genetically distinct individuals other than ourselves. In utero, we receive an infusion of them from mom, and women who become pregnant also collect a sampling shed by the developing embryo. That cells cross the placenta is not surprising. After all, the tissue that connects mother and child is not an impenetrable barricade. It is more like a selective border crossing, allowing passage, for instance. That border crossing allows passage of materials needed for the fetus's development. What is remarkable, however, is the extent to which migrant cells can persist in their new host. Circulating in the blood, even taking residence in various tissues, The intermingling of some cells from one person inside the body of another, a phenomenon termed microchimerism.
Watch out!
Microchimerism is now drawing intense scrutiny from medical researchers because recent work suggests it may contribute to both health and disease. Now, this was a piece written by J. Lee Nelson in Scientific American, and I wanted to bring it to your attention because the amazing idea that we actually share cells with our children, we actually share cells with our mother. The cells crawl from us when we're in the uterus into our mom and vice versa. Now, there are some recent studies which show that some of those cells can even help heal the mother. When the mother's tissues are damaged, some of those cells from the embryo can actually crawl in, say, to damaged parts of the brain or damaged parts of the liver and actually help heal the mother's body.
Internal stem cells.
Through stem cells, exactly. So I leave you with that piece of biological magic.
Ben Dubin-Taylor.
Can I ask a question?